again, and in this tutorial we are going to learn about how to set up a virtual environment and also install the Django web framework. Alright, so we quickly go to the Django girls tutorial and then we move to the chapter which include the virtual environment and how to install the Django framework. Alright, so to set up the virtual environment, we first need to launch our command prompt. So I'll quickly do that by using shortcut. Then I will make sure this move to the right side. Okay, so now we move to the Windows section. So we are supposed to create a directory called Django Girls, and then we change to that directory. Alright, so I'm going to change directory to the local disk and make the directory over there. So I'll type this. Then, alright, so what I actually did was to move from this directory, Noalohu, and I moved from, instead of me passing through this and this, I actually moved straight to the C. What I'm talking about is this, when you come to this place, look at the C. I was in this particular folder, Noalohu. This was where I was, but I quickly moved to C. Maybe I can only see this particular files. That's what I actually did over here. Alright, so for you to see what is going to happen now when I create a directory, I'll display that over there. Alright, so I'll make directory by doing this and then write Django Girls. Alright, so what I'm actually doing over here is to create a folder, like normal creating a folder, right click, then come to new and then folder. But this time around, we are using the command to do that particular process or that particular way of creating a folder. Alright, so we realize I've created a folder called Django Girls, and yep. Alright, so the next thing to do is to change directory. So change directory Django Girls, and hit enter. What I actually did over there is like opening this particular folder in the command prompt. See how nice it is. Alright, so I'll quickly close this. We don't need that now. Alright, so the next thing to do is to install the virtual environment. And I'll do that by typing Python-m virtual environment, then my virtual environment. Alright, so what I just did is to type this line of code, this particular one, I mean this. Alright, so what I just did was to type this. Okay, you don't need to type Python 35 or anything, just go straight to, since we've already installed the Python in our command prompt. Now hit enter. Alright, so it takes some time for it to do the set up the virtual environment. So it takes some time. Nice one, it has successfully installed or set up the virtual environment for us. Alright, so the next thing to do is to activate that. So we quickly, alright, so working with Windows. Alright, so what I actually, so now what you are supposed to do is to activate the virtual environment. So to do that, you're going to type this particular script. This, I will quickly zoom this for you. Alright, so this is what you will be typing now. So the name of the virtual environment, which is this, and I can copy that, then paste. Then you do this, then you write the scripts and activate. All right, nice. We've successfully set up the virtual environment and it is working. So this is what we should expect. All right, so when you successfully activate that, you should see this attached to There, see, so you realize you have the my virtual environment in over here as well. All right, so then the next thing to do is to install the Django or framework. So to do that, we type PIP, then install. You have to install, you have to upgrade the PIP, then upgrade PIP, then hit enter. Alright, so you have to be connected to the internet to be able to do this. Then quickly show this. Alright, so it's already up to date, so no need for me to panic. Alright, so another thing that we are supposed to do is to install. Alright, so the next thing to do is to install the Django framework. So you write PIP and say install Django. All right, so you can decide to include the version over there, or just ignore it and just type Django. Then it automatically download the Django from online for us. So you can see it's downloading the version 1.11.5. Internet is not very fast. Great, that's finished downloading. Now the next thing is to install the collected packages. So you have to wait patiently for it to do all that. Nice one. We have successfully installed Django on our machine. All right, so so at the end of this, we've learned how to set up the virtual environment and also install the Django web framework. Thank you for watching, and I hope you watch the next video. Bye.